Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and we are securing our data today. What else would you do on a rainy Sunday afternoon? What we're doing is we're taking discs that Rick has made over the years, and he's transferred the information to a more modern media, and now we have all of these from all of his artwork and his pictures that he's taken that we do not want to just throw in the garbage, because you never know whose hands it might end up in. So instead, we're taking these discs apart. We're salvaging where the data is. We will shred this and put this in the garbage. But we're recycling, just like when you recycle in a garden, we're recycling the plastic parts and the aluminum parts and even the little steel springs that are inside. So Rick will show you how to do it. He's faster than I.
Well, basically, you just peel off the metal, the aluminum, pop that in there, and then you basically crack this open.
You have to watch out for that little spring.
You pull out the data, but there's also a little interesting little metal spring in here. My spring has sprung. Oh, there it is. I see it. Right here, this tiny little piece of metal. In fact, you can see it probably better on the disc. So we're salvaging those, and we're going to put those in a special container. And then we're also salvaging these aluminum center discs. But this is the important part of the data. Now you got to understand that in 1900...
Ooh, you're old.
No, actually, I think I started archiving all the information that we worked on back in 1983 when we had the big floppy disks. And then, of course, when technology improved, we ended up with these soft shell or these hard shell floppy disks. But all of this information that you see here, all of this information fit on about one third of a DVD disk. All of this information. And again, this is our business files, our art files, everything we've done
personal
in the garden,
files.
Personal files. All of this is recorded on these magnetic or tape-like disks. And what we have to do now is separate the data from just the plastic shell, and these are what we're going to actually destroy and shred. Because again, in today's world, you never know. I mean, if we just took this to the recycling center or just put it in the garbage and in a bag, we don't know what would really happen to this.
Who's dumpster diving?
You know. And so it's important in today's world that if you do have old information, I mean, most computers today don't even allow for a little floppy disk like this. You can buy external USBs, drives, and put one in, but think of all the data that you might have stored over the years, especially if you've been working with computers like we have since 1983, when we got our first Atari and Commodore computers. Then we went to Milwaukee PC, and we had two huge towers built. And we literally had to tell them what we needed. So anyhow, today's work is ahead of us. We've got to recycle all this stuff and, again, ultimately shred this information. So, you know, it's just a simple process of extracting.
Not poking yourself in the eye.
Without poking, right? Yeah. You know, you may want to wear glasses just to protect yourself, which I often do.
Or letting the little springs jump into your
coffee
cup.
Yeah, those little springs are dangerous.
Yeah, we're all wearing glasses, and we will definitely be vacuum cleaning, because these little guys have little prongs on the end, so they get caught on things quite easily. You don't want them popping in your coffee or in your eye or getting stuck in your carpeting.
Well, here's a question that I have for everyone. Now, obviously, those of you that are young, you probably have never even worked with a little floppy disk like this. You may have seen them, wondered what they were.
In the museum.
But for those of us who have, think of the DVD discs that you now have that maybe you've been putting information on. 10 years from now, you're going to have to transfer that to whatever the new technology is. So that's the other part too, that some of these discs actually worked. Some of them had problems, disc errors and so forth, couldn't read it. Maybe this little disc in some way, shape was damaged. And so even though you had important information on here, you couldn't even access it. So I've got several really large zip drives that I've also had to destroy. I think we have probably about 100 of those, because that was the next technology after this, because a zip drive could probably hold about 20, 25 of these. So, you know, now with the DVD, like I said, when we burn them, this is nothing. You know, it doesn't even come close to filling half of a DVD. So that shows you how powerful and how much information can be there. And we're talking about images, you know, Photoshop images. So, you know, we've got our work cut out for us, and once this is done, we can start on all the really hard shell zip drives, too, that we have to destroy.
Oh, goody.
Yeah. Oh, that's how we're spending our day, recycling. Instead of being out in the garden, we're recycling inside the house.
Okay, so this is what you're looking for. First, you take off the top part. Sometimes it's plastic, sometimes it's metal.
If it's metal, we keep it.
We recycle, right?
And then?
Careful of that spring, because that spring is hiding up at the top.
Yeah. Yeah. And what's interesting is inside of these little pads, sometimes there are these little metal things, and they're just sticking right in here. I don't see one. Oh, here. Now, this one has a little plastic. Clear plastic.
That's been glued down. Must have some kind of data
on it. And this, you know, if it's not plastic, then it's this little thin sheet of metal.
So we're
probably aluminum.
We're keeping that one, too?
Yeah, we're hanging on to these little metal pieces, but this is all plastic.
And what are we going to do with these, all this metal, when we get it collected?
Well, we'll either donate it to a school that's having, you know, an aluminum. You know how they use the tabs from a soda bottle?
Mm-hmm.
You know, maybe they can use this. But again, this is the important data disk. This is where all that information is stored. And this is really what you want to
shred
and destroy, just to make sure no one else gets their hands on your personal information.
We hope you find that this information that we're doing is important to you, and if you have discs and information, either take them to a professional shredder who knows how to get rid of these and who knows how to protect your data, or have the fun like we're having with our son today and tear apart your discs and protect your data. If you found it important and interesting, please give us a thumbs up. We'd love to have your comments and questions, and we'd love to have you join our garden family and subscribe.
Hey, maybe we could use these as Frisbees. You want to try one?
Well, I remember you used to use those shiny ones as
art. Yes.
For the garden.
I would have them hanging off of trees. I'd put 100 of them together, mm-hmm. kind of like a windshine,
right.
And they would sparkle, and people would see these from blocks away and come up here. What is that, you know? But that
those
was
are pretty.
That was back in probably about 1996, 95 when we started doing that.
They didn't last too long, though.
No. The sun kind of warm out, but such is life.
Bye for now.
Connect with us on YouTube.